नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, Srimahans, Mahans, Tanedas, Kotaris, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, Lotus News Channel, Sadhana TV, Janashri TV, Ishwar TV, and through two-way video conferencing, having Nayanadeeksha in 30 cities, many countries around the world. Cities sitting with us in two-way video conferencing, having Nayanadeeksha, Singapore, Singapuram, Ohio, Prayag, Seattle, Chidambaram, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Kuala Lumpur, Palani, Haridwar, Varanasi, Nityananda Nagaramu, Hyderabad, Seremban, Shivakashi, Charlotte, Srisailam, Nityananda Nagara, Bididi, Nityananda Nagara, Thiruvannamalai, Koyamuttur, Dhyanapeetam, London, Kashi, Scottsdale, Arizona, Houston, Kalahasti, Dakota Dunes, Dubai, Vaidyanatham, Tune Moon, Hong Kong, High Pine, North Carolina, Indrani, New Jersey, Anne Mary, Paris, Adinityananda Dhyanapeetam, Avattipalayam, Hyderabad, Gupta Kashi, Hong Kong, Sirgali, Abu Dhabi, Slovakia, Bobrad, Oman, Sivagangai, China, Rosli, Winston, Salem, North Carolina, Coimbatore, Dhyanapeetam, Houston, Kalahasti, Port Washington, New York, Nityananda University, Paris, Nityananda University, Los Angeles, Dubai, Vaidyanatham, Dakota Dunes, High Point, North Carolina. I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. I'll start on the process of living Advaita, the Timili. I'll continue. See, when you work with all your incompletions, I gave you the time today, with the help of Timili, you will pen down all the incompletions you need to complete with to achieve your authentic identity. Please listen. Just like the same cloth, because of confusion, gets into the knot and fights with the same cloth. This is the same one piece cloth, but when it starts getting confused about itself, when it's not sure about itself, it gets locked here and there and gets knotted. Once the knot happens, the cloth itself is fighting with itself. Neither it is going to be useful, nor it is going to have longevity. It will destroy itself. That is exactly our own inner space is doing. I do not want to use the word mind for our inner space, because the word mind is polluted too much. Our own inner space is doing to ourselves. Our own inner space is, this is what our own inner space is doing to itself. That's the right word. You can see the deep tiredness you cherish, kind of a, the deep rooted pattern of give up. That is the source of all your tiredness, boredom and pains. Do not ever entertain that. Please understand. Do not ever entertain that. whatever field you may be, you might have achieved the peak of your field. You would have taken up your career in a company and you become CEO. But still, if you have not completed with the deep-rooted pattern of giving up, you have not seen your peak. Please be very clear. You may be an accidental prime minister, accidental chief executive officer, accidental chief minister, accidental religious leader, or accidental adhinam. You may not have achieved your full potential. Please listen. See, from the young age, people who oppose you, people whom you think are against you, it'll not be some top big guys like a prime minister, president of the country is opposing you, the mitai wala who sells candy in your street corner, all your enemies will be only that level. You gave 50 paise, he gave candy only for 45 paise, and 5 paise he cheated you. These are the complaints you will start developing in your life. When you start building the idea that some enemies you have, some people are cheating you, some are exploiting you, slowly, slowly, your over-remembrance about them makes you shrink and stop you deciding in your continuous expansion. That is why in our Gurukul I said, even getting the fruits and eating in the garden, our Rishi Advaita was telling, we will get all the mangoes and serve them one day in the lunch or dinner. I said, have you eaten like that when you were a child? When you steal and eat only, it is tasty. Not when it is served for everyone. So have more trees. Kids can, now we don't even need to use the word stealing. You see, it's like a, if it is banned and they do it, only then it is called stealing. Because no other way I use the word stealing, we should not even use the word stealing for our kids. Because we never ban them. I only tell them, tell your tree, let it give 10 times more mango and all of you enjoy, that's all. So there is no question of stealing. Because they are the owners, they are the inheritors. So it is their own father's property. You can't even use the word stealing. But anyhow, we always feel tasty when we directly pluck and eat, share only with the people with whom we love. That's a kind of a pattern with which we start growing. That is okay. Anyhow, listen, the idea I am trying to convey to you, the over-remembrance of enemies and the enmity constantly tires you. It is like the AC machine is switched on even when you are traveling somewhere else. Even when you are away, the AC machine is running whole day and night. When you enter the room, it will be repaired. You have gone away 2 years somewhere and the AC machine is switched on and it is constantly running day and night. And if it is constantly running, whether you are there or not, when you come back, the machine will be repaired and you won't have any cooling effect. Please listen, that is exactly what we are doing with our inner space. The over-remembrance of enmity and enemy uses all your energy constantly, and when you really need power, you don't have. Like AC machine used all that time, when you really need it, will not work, will not be useful. The constant remembrance of enmity and enemy will do the overwork of the inner space. When you really need power, you won't have it. Please listen. The constant remembrance of enemy or enmity damages your inner space so much, even for a small decision, you have to go through so much to come to the conclusion. You have to go through so much to come to the conclusion. Listen. Because of the constant cherishing of enmity or enemy, you come to a space kind of that giving up. Okay, I leave it. That giving up, please listen, that giving up is the most dangerous pattern, I can say, poisonous strategy you build about your life. Poisonous strategy. I wanted to remind all of you this word, poisonous strategy. Even if you are poisoned physically, you can be cured, you can be recovered. But your strategy about life is poison. Nothing can be done. Completion with your strategy about life immediately makes you enlightened. Completion with your perception about life, completion with your conversation about life, because your classmate stole 2 candies from your hand, you decide never to store them in your hand, always eat it away. That decision can go up to your whole life and never let you save for future, always spending it away. That small pattern can run throughout your life. Till the end, it can make you decide never to store or save, go on spending it. Because the subtle constant fear you will be lost, it will be taken away, will be there. When constantly that fear, that remembrance, the over-remembrance, please understand, the over-remembrance of non-reality, non-existential informations is perversion. The over-remembrance of the joy which is non-existential becomes greed. The over-remembrance of the fear which is non-existential becomes the getting terrorized. Understand? Over-remembrance of the joys which is non-existent becomes greed. The over-remembrance of the pains which is non-existence becomes fear. The over-remembrance, people come and ask me sometime, Swamiji, give me memory power. I think, oh God, you don't know what you are asking. The mess you are getting into, the over-remembrance of the past failures and enemies can completely make you psychologically impotent. Understand? The psychologically important. That is why in India, we infuse right remembrance. All the great spiritual practices in India, you can see, will always be infusing right remembrance. If you are afraid of death, you are asked to meditate on it, come to terms with it. Understand, coming to terms with it is not accepting or committing suicide. You are not asked to commit suicide in Varanasi, but you are asked to come to terms with that reality. Your suffering is because of over-remembrance about death, not about the real death. In this inner awakening in Varanasi, you are going to go through a unique, special death process, and in the same space of Vishwanatha, where I myself went through. Listen, it is not committing suicide, or it is not inviting death earlier, it is just becoming powerful about death, not falling into powerlessness by the remembrance and indirect reminders of death. Understand? Indirect reminders of death is what? Old age, disease, remembrance, or the reminders of death should not make you powerless. That's all is coming to terms with death. I sincerely recommend and request, if any of you want to do something best to your father and mother, send them to Varanasi Inner Awakening. That will be the greatest gift, best gift you can give it to them. Send them to Varanasi, because I can guarantee they will come to terms with death. Death and reminders of death will not make them powerless. Understand? Memory of death and reminders of death, both are separate. Memory of death is you thinking about death. Reminders of death is even your grey hair. One hair which has become white. From that to any disease, all of that is reminders of death. Nothing of this will make you powerless. Reminders of death will not make you powerless. So please understand, the over remembrance of enemy or enmity can psychologically make you impotent, unable to decide about anything in the life, and when you sit with your timili, you will find that deep-rooted wounds happened in your life, which is responsible for your constant shrinking, decisive mentality. I have seen some of the people who come to volunteer our programs. Constantly they will be shrinking. I have one brahmachari also. All that time, where he is, nobody knows. He is in some bhutaloka. Really. That is why I gave him the name. Come back to the eternal space. Don't be in the bhuta space. To come back to the real space. Eternal space means real space. This psychological impotency happens because of constant remembrance about your enmity failures. Please understand. Do not confuse psychological impotency with psychological mutation. Mutation is totally different. Mutation is coming to terms with the reality and going beyond the necessity of the external world. Psychological impotency means, listen, psychological impotency means unable to believe anything is possible, deciding it is impossible before even you start. So I give you few more days for all of you to pen down your incompletions based on the input of the Timili and your own contemplation. Finally, the whole thing will boil down to your psychological impotency. Your own decisions about yourself strongly. See, the decisions like I cannot do yoga every day is done in a superficial muscle memory level. Decisions like I cannot quit smoking is done the little deeper muscle memory level. Decisions like I cannot fly, I am a man or a woman, woman or man are not designed for flying. All these decisions are made in the biomemory level. Any impossibility is impossibility with which you need to complete. How many of you still dream once in a while as if you are flying in the dream? You guys are blessed. You should complete with your decision of not to fly. I am not saying you will start flying, but if you complete with the decision, the heaviness which grounds you all the time will melt down. If you don't need to fly, if you are confident of flying, your decisions constantly in your life will be in flying colors. People who dream that they fly have higher possibility for getting enlightened by working on their jagra swapna sushupti, by working on their waking dream and deep sleep state. They have higher possibility for enlightenment. Listen. That is why I am saying, every impossibility, whether it is as simple as I cannot do morning yoga, or as difficult and complicated as I cannot fly, should be completed. Listen. Whether it is dogs 1, 2, 3 or your own 1, 2, 3. It has to be cleaned. Both cannot be allowed inside the house. Whether it is as simple as I cannot do yoga to as difficult as I cannot fly, whole thing has to be completed. And I tell you, if you complete as simple things as I cannot do morning yoga, I cannot wake up in the early morning, I am not able to stop fighting with my husband, the moment I see him, all my kundalini awakens in the wrong direction. These simple things, if you complete, suddenly you will have such a possibility opening up. completing with the big patterns like I cannot fly will not be difficult at all. You will simply do it. All I wanted to tell you through today's satsang, continue to dig out and pen down all the incompletions. With the support and help of your timili and your own contemplation and intra-analyzing. Few more days we have time to complete with all the incompletions, with your timili, with all the incompletions. So understand, maybe after 2 days, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, the third day, I'll start the completion process, because unless you dig out all the incompletions, starting the completion process is going to be useless. Dig out everything, I'll put fire once for all and finish all the incompletions. Let's not do it part by part, because sometime if you think there are some ideas, thoughts which are not your incompletions, which is your own, but which are incompletions, if I put fire on them, you will feel as if I am burning you, not your incompletions. So before I put fire, you need to know which is your tumor and which is your muscle. Otherwise, you will try to fight with me, saying that I am putting fire on your muscle. I never do that. I only put fire on your tumor. I only cut your tumor, never your muscle. Neither 1 inch low or 1 inch more. 1 inch more or 1 inch less. I am a precise surgeon. I neither bring unnecessary suffering to you, nor bring unnecessary complications to you. I neither support your incompletion, nor will bring 1 inch extra suffering to you. I operate with a tremendous compassion, love as anesthesia. So please listen, my love is the space in which I operate. My compassion is the space in which I operate. So that is why I wanted 2 more days for all of you to recognize your incompletions. Once you recognize, destroying them is my job. Even now I can get into your inner space and finish off all the incompletions. But you will abuse me, complain about me that I am hurting you. Because many of your incompletions, you strongly believe them as you. You stop believing them as you, destroying them, completing them is my responsibility. So I give you 2 more days to diagnose and recognize all your incompletions. I bless you all, let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation